Let's solve this differential equation. We have dx dt is equal to t over x times e to the t plus 2x power. How is this separable? Yes, it is, because if you look at t plus 2x, they are in the exponent, right? We can use one of the rule of exponents. We can separate it. If you look at this right here as t on the top over x right here, when you add the exponent, it's the same as multiply e to this, e to that, right? So I can look at this as e to the t times e to the 2x. So let me write this down right here. We have dx dt is equal to, let me just put down all the x together first, okay? So we will have 1 over x right here, and then e to the 2x together like this. And this right here is a function of x. And then we multiply by t on the top over e to the t on the side right here. So you see, it is separable. And now, you see here we have dx over dt. Let's multiply dt on both sides so that they cancel. And I want to bring all the x together to the other side, right? So let's multiply x e to the 2x. So they cancel. I'll have to do it right here as well. X e to the 2x. And this right here are good because all the t's are together. So altogether, right here we'll have x e to the 2x, and this is dx, and this is equal to integrate t over e to the t, I will have to look at this as t times e to the negative t dt. Okay? Because I recognize I have to do integration by parts right here, I also have to do integration by parts right here. So integrate this, integrate that, and the best way to do integration by part is of course to use the DI method. I'll do a DI method right here real quick. Plus minus on the side, I think I need 3 of them. So let's put the D right here as the X, and then I, let's integrate e to the 2X. And to differentiate X, we get 1 and then 0. And then to integrate this, we have 1 half e to the 2X, and then integrate it again, we have 1 over 4 e to the 2X, right? So after we integrate this, running through the DI method with the integration by parts, right? This is pretty much the answer. Don't forget the sign on the side, plus minus. And when you do the diagonals, they are the answers already. So we will have x times this, which is 1 half x, and then e to the 2x. Next, we have this times that, which is minus 1 over 4 e to the 2x. This is it for that, right? And I'm not going to put on plus a constant here because I just have to do it on the right hand side. Let's focus on integrating this right here. And once again, we need to use the DI method for the integration by parts. I need 3 of them, 3 rows. Let's differentiate t, so we get 1 and 0. Let's integrate e to the negative t. Right here, we will have negative e to the negative t. Do it again. Negative, negative becomes positive, so we will just have e to the negative t, positive right here. Diagonals are the answer. This is 0, so it's great. Bring down the equal sign. First, we have this times that, which is negative t, e to the negative t, and this times that, negative 1 times that, which is negative e to the negative t power. Okay? So that's the integral for that. This is the integral result for that. And I will just put on plus c right here. X is the dependent variable, and t was the independent variable. There's nearly no way to isolate the x, right? So we'll leave the answer right here. Okay, this is it. And when you cannot solve for the dependent variable, this right here is called the implicit solution. Okay, sometimes if you can solve for x, we can solve for the y. If you can solve for the dependent variable, that's called the explicit solution. But this is called implicit solution. And this is it.